Hi, everybody, and welcome to worship. This is a time of great change. We've been talking about it for a few weeks in our e-worship service, and today is our last Sunday of being in worship together through South Presbyterian Church and Irondequoit Presbyterian Church. Don't worry, services will continue. Let me explain. I am retiring from those churches as their pastor. However, I remain as the executive director of Firebird Spirit, which is an independent nonprofit working to spread hope across the land. And we will continue these worship services just in a different location. This is my last Sunday to be in person with both of those churches. And so some of this service will be the same as what they are experiencing in person, and other parts of it will be different. We began these online worship services with the beginning of COVID as a way to stay connected. And that was 4 years ago, over 4 years ago. But then we found out that others of you were joining us as well, and we were so excited about that. Last year alone, we had, without any advertising, we had over 3,000 views of our worship services. So we know that they are important, and we will continue them. Although South Presbyterian and Irondequoit Presbyterian churches will no longer be recording these every week, we will continue, as I said, to offer them through Firebird Spirit, a nonprofit that we have told you about in the past. It will essentially be the same format, but with some new people added as leaders and a fresher look to our graphics, for instance. The e-worship services will be uploaded on Fridays, just as they are now, to our new YouTube channel, at Firebird Spirit Hope. If you go to that channel and hit subscribe, you will be notified when we post new things on the channel. At Firebird Spirit Hope. It's important to have the at sign at the beginning. At Firebird Spirit Hope. Or you can follow the link that is on the home page of our website, firebirdspirit.org. That will also get you to the YouTube page. Either way, we hope to see you there. Make the jump with us, and let's see where the Spirit will take us, shall we? Tell your friends. Invite them. Now, with all of the changes and endings and transitions that we're all going through as part of my leaving these churches, our centering question for today is this. What are a couple of the most important things that you have learned about yourself or about your faith in the last 4 years since COVID? My guess is that there are a lot of things. Things you might have taken for granted and suddenly you didn't, or things you never really thought about but suddenly you did. And then reintegrating into life. The post-COVID life. What has that been like? What have you learned about yourself or about your faith in the 4 years since COVID? I invite you to hit the pause button, take as long as you need to kind of settle in with this. It will put you in a good place for our worship service. If you're worshiping with others in the same room, maybe have a conversation. What are some of the most important things that you've learned, ways you've changed? Learned about yourself or about your faith. Ready? When you release it, we'll continue with a call to worship. Pause.
Greetings from Greensboro, North Carolina. We open our worship today with words from Psalm 139 and Matthew 6. Let us call each other to worship and invite God's presence to be with us. Where can we go from your spirit? Where can we flee from your presence? For you created our inmost being. You knit us together in our mother's wombs. Jesus tells us, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Instead, seek first God's kingdom and God's righteousness, and all these things will be given unto you. Let us worship the living God. Our opening hymn is personally one of my favorites, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Andy?
That every week it is a good thing to get realigned with God and God's plan for our lives. Wherever you are, we hope that you will do the same as we come together and pray in unison. It is so easy for us to diminish the gifts you have given us, loving God. We have come to believe that either we are experts in some areas or we know nothing. Each of us has been given special talents and gifts that can be used to help others. But for some reason, we often think that our gifts are inadequate. Remind us of your perfect plan when we think less of ourselves. Help us look at the blessings that you have poured into our lives and to discover the special talents that we have. Open the doorways of service and let the gates of your grace swing wide that we may go serve you as one and as followers of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
In Paul's letter to the Romans, we hear these instructions for living out our faith. Wherever you are, I invite you to join me in Arizona in proclaiming the good news together using the Message version of Romans 12, verses 1 and 2, and 9 through 21. Listen for God's instructions to you this day as we read together responsibly. So here's what I want you to do, God helping you. Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life, and place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing that you can do for God. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You'll be changed from the inside out. Readily recognize what God wants from you and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down to its level of immaturity, God brings out the best of you, develops well-formed maturity in you. Love from the center of who you are. Don't fake it. Run for dear life from evil and hold on for dear life to good. Be good friends who love deeply. Practice playing second fiddle. Don't burn out. Keep yourselves fueled and aflame. Be alert servants of the Master, cheerfully expectant. Don't quit in hard times. Pray all the harder. Help needy Christians. Be inventive in hospitality. Bless your enemies. No cursing under your breath. Laugh with your happy friends when they're happy, and share tears when they're down. Get along with each other. Don't be stuck up. Make friends with nobodies. Don't be the great somebody. Don't hit back. Discover beauty in everyone. If you've got it in you, get along with everybody. Don't insist on getting even. That's not for you to do. I'll do the judging, says God. I'll take care of it. Our scriptures tell us that if you see your enemy hungry, go buy that person lunch. Or if he's thirsty, get him a drink. Your generosity will surprise him with goodness. Don't let evil get the best of you. Get the best of evil by doing good. Behold the Spirit's word for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
By the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in darkened sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Break their hearts of stone, give them
Just in case you're wondering, because I know some of you listen to this and then go to one of these worship services, this is not the same thing that I will be preaching in person, where we have much longer history together in those places. But the question is the same for us all. How do we go from here? It's not just in terms of our worship experience. How do we go from here? How does our country go forth from here? What are the next steps? How do we move forward in saving our environment? How does the world go forward without finding itself ensconced in regional wars of proxy states? How do we protect our children and our communities from violence, from gunfire, from racist and bigoted attitudes and encounters? How do we raise our families, our children and our grandchildren, to share the same values that we do when their world is changing so quickly and so dramatically? The other day I heard a young gentleman. His name is Dylan Douglas. You might have seen him or heard of him yourself. He's in his early 20s, I think. He is interviewing people for his radio show on Sirius XM. It's a show for Gen Zers, you know, those who were born between 1997 and 2012. So they're between the ages of like 12 and 27 right now. They say born between 1997, and they are 27, 12 years to 27 years old. For the most part, they were born after 9/11. They've never been going to school when there weren't school shooter drills. Until 2021, so the majority of their lives, right? The United States has had troops stationed in war zones, the longest of which was Afghanistan. So their country has always been at war for them for most of their lives. It's only the last 3 years we haven't been. If they were born in the early part of that time, 97 on, George W. Bush was their president for 8 of those years, and he was followed by Barack Obama for another 8. So they've grown up seeing a black man as a president. They've also experienced children being ripped from their parents' arms at our border. They've seen police brutality put on trial following the murder of George Floyd. And young boys of color cut down by gunfire from those who were expected to protect them. They have seen a president impeached twice. And they've seen a Supreme Court change the law of the land after 50 years, despite the fact that 70%+ of Americans supported that law. How that generation sees us going on may or may not be the way that some of us do, who have considerable more years on them, a different perspective. So what do we do with that information as followers of Jesus? How do we go on? Well, one way is to pay attention to Paul and his advice to the beginning church in Rome. We read, "So here's what I want you to do, God helping you. Take your everyday, ordinary life. Your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life. And place it before God as an offering. Whatever we are, whoever we are, whatever we are doing, thinking, saying, feeling, give it to God. Place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for God. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You'll be changed from the inside out. Readily recognize what God wants from you and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down to its level of immaturity, God brings the best out of you and develops well-formed maturity in you. When we live as if our life is an offering to God, we get outside of ourselves, right? We see things differently. We're not so stuck in our old ways. When we live as Jesus followers, we won't fit in. And that's okay. It's more than okay. That's a good thing. Doing life that way changes us from the inside out. And it changes the world. And the next part reads like, everything I learned about life I learned in kindergarten. Love from the center of who you are. Don't fake it. Run for dear life from evil. Hold on for dear life to good. Be good friends. Practice playing second fiddle. You don't have to be the best, the show off, the know-it-all. Don't burn out. Take care of yourself. Be alert, cheerfully expectant. Don't quit in hard times, but pray all the harder. Help people. Be inventive in hospitality. Bless your enemies. Laugh and cry with your friends. Get along with each other. Don't be stuck up. Make friends with nobodies. Don't hit back. Look for beauty. Don't insist on getting your own way. Trust God. And that's just about the best advice we can get, I think. I mean, how do we go from here? With the help of God. We can't do life on our own, but with God, all things are possible because Jesus showed us how. So, my friends, don't give up. Stay the course. Keep the faith. And let the people of God say, Amen. We support each other in Christ's ministry, and our gifts support those programs that touch the lives of others, even outside of our congregations here and where you are. So let us give as we are able for the work of the Spirit in the world today. Andy? Please pray with me. We ask three things of you in our gift-giving, O Christ: to see thee more clearly, to love thee more dearly, and to follow thee more nearly day by day. And in so doing, may we bear witness to all that we are in you. Amen. Take my life and let it be. A nice song to help us prepare to meet God in prayer. Let's sing together.
Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them
Let's pray. O Holy One and Holy Deliverer, you who lead us into and through these seasons of change in our lives, you who offer us new beginnings every day, we give thanks for all that has been and for all that will be. We give thanks for families, those that come to us by birth and those that come to us by choice. Families who love and accept us as we are. Families who believe in us and who we can believe in. We give thanks for friends and neighbors, for those in our faith community, however widespread it is, and however it is that we define that. We give thanks for the blessings that we receive every day. as children of the living God, as siblings of the risen Christ. Wherever we are, watch over us and bless us, we ask. Keep us connected to each other through you and your Spirit. Empower us to be channels for your light in the world. And never, ever, ever let us forget how much you love us. Even in those moments when we may not love ourselves. For we long to live more like Jesus, in whose name we pray together as he taught us, saying, Our God in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We have another hymn for today, an extra. Comes to us from our rich tradition of hymns. Let us join Andy in God of Grace and God of Glory. It is good to occasionally pause and state that which we believe, together, as the people of God, as the Church of Jesus Christ. Please join me as we speak responsively this statement of faith. Our hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' love and righteousness. If we take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there God's hand shall lead us, and God's right hand shall hold us. The one who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And we will say, God is our refuge and our fortress. In God alone will we trust. We worship the God of Abraham and Sarah, the God of Moses and Miriam, the God of Jesus and Mary, the God of every person who embodies the spirit of justice love in bringing us closer to the time when all are one. We worship the living God, the God of the ages. We follow the resurrected and living Christ who was, who is, and who will always be, now and forever. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, for whom there is no time or space, we are one, proclaiming the kingdom until it is done on earth as it is in heaven. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Our closing hymn for this service will be the unofficial theme song of South Presbyterian Church. Let us join Andy in singing For Everyone Born.
Just an unjust, a new way.
We thank you for your faithfulness to worshiping together and forming this community online. We hope that you will come with us and help to form the new Firebird Spirit Worship online as well. Again, go to @FirebirdSpiritHope on YouTube and become a follower, a subscriber. In the near future, we will also be on Instagram and on Facebook. You can always check us out at our website, firebirdspirit.org. So leave here all that burdens you. Take with you all that is good and right and noble and of God, because that is what the world is thirsting for. And we are the ones that God trusts to deliver the life-giving message of hope and reconciliation. Let us go with God and walk with Jesus and dance in the Spirit, and let the people of God proclaim, Amen. Stick around for the postlude. Andy's got a special one for you. Until next time, over at Firebird Spirit, we'll say, I say, thank you. Let us go with God. Be safe, take care, and bye for now. Thank you for joining us today. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here, and we are glad that you chose to worship with us. We are grateful for your prayerful support of our ministries. We are a small congregation of about 50 members in upstate New York, but now we find ourselves growing to include some of you in North Carolina, Connecticut, Florida, Kentucky, Utah, Colorado, Arizona, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and other parts of New York State, and maybe other places that we are not even aware of. All of us united by the Spirit of the living and loving God. If you are watching this, we already think that you are part of us, and we would love to hear from you. Should you find yourself in the Rochester, New York area, we would welcome you to worship with us in person. Please check our website calendar for the nearest location. If you would like us to pray for you, please send those joys or concerns to me through our website, which is noted at the end of this video. More worship services, as well as our weekday meditations, Prayerful Pause with the Pastor, can be found on our YouTube channel, South Church Rochester. If you are in a position to help support us financially, your gifts may be sent to us as seen on your screen. We hope that you have a great week, and we look forward to seeing you back here again. Just remember, transform your spirit, transform our world. Okay, God bless, and bye for now.